Hello and welcome to the Retro Workshop. Well, I'm out of the workshop today and at the NEC in Birmingham for the Classic Motor Show, where I'm on the Sinclair C5 owner's stand. We've got a couple of interesting machines, a couple of prototypes, an interesting coin-operated C5, and some nicely restored machines with different accessories. So join me as I take a look around the stand and around the show.
Members of the C5 owners group brought our machines along to exhibit at the NEC in Birmingham, alongside other classic and historic vehicles. We displayed a selection of C5s, some examples in great condition, showing the various optional accessories such as side panels, indicators, mirrors and the high-vis mast. We also had a C5 without the canopy, showing off the Lotus design chassis and revealing the fact that the C5 is based on a recumbent bicycle. And other rare and unusual C5s were on display.
Hi everyone, my name's Sam. I'm just going to explain a little bit about this recently found Lotus prototype. So this was found summer 2023. And it was on a Facebook marketplace, but it was a box of bits. Now there's a few differences which were a telltale sign that this was a prototype from the original production of the C5. It's actually a different material and it's smooth instead of with the kind of texture that we get on the production model. But I think most obvious are probably the grey stickers at the front. So grey hand cut stickers and also a very different yellow sticker on the front wheel cover. There's a few differences towards the back. We've got square stickers instead of our angled ones. We've got a thicker rear axle, a smaller star nut, and the tyres are, I think, 40 psi instead of 35 psi. So very small differences kind of throughout as well. Now this was found in a box of bits for the show here at the NEC Classic Car Show. I've used all the original bolts that I could find in the box. I had to get the Dremel out, clean up all the threads, grease them up to try and get it into one piece to try and tell the story to everyone here at the show today. There's kind of an interesting history behind this other than it being a prototype. In the long video, the 20-minute like infomercial on YouTube, this can be seen riding up and down the ramps by someone I've met called Young Ken, a classic Team Lotus, who is now retired from Lotus, but he was a teenager riding this at the time, did his entire career at Lotus following the C5 project. On the far side, we've got number 29. Now, that was from the Electrathon race in Donington Park in 1986. Now, we've managed to trace the rider who rode that in 86, and hopefully we can get in touch with them soon and find out their story. So here it is. It survives. I think this is like one of two, although we've heard that there might be a third here after talking to some people at the show. We've got some special C5s, and I'm sure John will talk about his one as well.
Hi, my name is John, and this is my Sinclair C5 coin operated. This one is slightly different from a standard C5. It doesn't have any pedals on the vehicle. It's operated by the use of the old 50 pence. You put your 50p into the coin slot and that will give you a limited amount of time which can be set on the controls inside, anything between a minute and 10 minutes of use. There's a coin box to collect your 50 pences. This C5 was designed to be used on a Blackpool seafront, but they were quite common in a number of theme parks and attractions throughout the UK in the mid-80s. So it's a great way of using up the old stock of Sinclairs that didn't sell, that could be used and generate money for the owners. It's different in the way that it doesn't have the standard controls. It works via a relay system, which is direct drive onto the motor. So it is basically a standard C5 with just this added fixture on the front. We don't know how many of these were converted or used. I've had this one for about 6 years, and I've used it from time to time, but I haven't got many old 50p's.
the Sinclair C5 was touted as a revolutionary electric vehicle, but it certainly wasn't the first EV. Not far from the C5 stand was another showcasing the Enfield 8000, first introduced in 1973. This compact two-seater was powered by an electric motor and lead-acid batteries, with an even more limited production run than the C5, with around 100 having been produced. Looking around the other halls at the NEC is a real treat for any vehicle enthusiast. The quality of the paint jobs on some of the cars is astounding. They never looked that good when they were new. Of course, I stopped by to look at the DeLoreans, a car with a special link to the Sinclair C5, as Barry Wills, former managing director of Sinclair Vehicles, also worked for DeLorean. Two iconic 80s vehicles, both sadly failures in the market. The Sinclair C5 owners will once again have a stand at the 2024 Classic Motor Show. So do stop by and take a look if you're attending. Bye for now.